हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल बेसिक्स ऑफ फिजिक्स बाय प्रोफेसर रवि किरण लाटे। एंड फ्रॉम टुडेज ऑनवर्ड्स विल बी स्टार्टिंग विद द मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड ऑन द आवर सेकंड पेपर, दैट इज नथिंग बट द हीट एंड थर्मोडायनेमिक्स। सो इन टुडेज लेक्चर विल बी डिस्कसिंग द एमसीक्यूज बेस्ड ओवर द टॉपिक वैन डर वाल्स इक्वेशन ऑफ स्टेट, आइसोथर्मल प्रोसेस, आइसोबारिक प्रोसेस एंड isobaric and adiabatic process. So before actually starting with the actual content of the multiple choice questions, let me first of all thank you all our viewers for supporting our channel. In the last 1 month only more than 10,000 views has been given to our videos, which is quite tremendous as far as our growth is concerned. I again thank you all the students, staff members and the colleagues for sharing this content with your friends and colleagues and the students. With this we'll just start with our MCQs. The first MCQ is the molecule of an ideal gas have the options are given below. The first option is only kinetic energy, next option is only potential energy, option C is both kinetic energy and potential energy, option D none of this. All of us know that in case of an ideal gas, the ideal gas molecules, they do not exert any kind of force on each other. Okay, so they are not having a force of attraction or repulsion between them. So but these gas molecules, they are always in random motion. Okay, so as these objects are, or these gas molecules are in always in random motion, so due to that one they have only the kinetic energy. So if you look it at the options in this case, then it will be the option A, which is nothing but the only kinetic energy. So in this case the correct option is only kinetic energy. Now next question, the equation of state for an adiabatic process is, it means we have to identify the correct equation of state. Equation of state is nothing but the equation which describes the state of a given system. It may be a relation between in terms of pressure, volume and temperature. Okay, so we have to predict an equation of state for an adiabatic process. The options are given over here. Option A, PV is equal to RT. Option B, PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. It's option C, PT raised to gamma is equal to constant. Option D, none of this. All of us know that the first option, PV is equal to RT, it is an equation of state for an isothermal process. Okay, it is an ideal gas equation. Okay, so for 1 mole of a gas, and for an adiabatic process, we have already discussed this relation. Okay, in our earlier lectures series, you can see in the playlist heat and thermodynamics. You can watch this lecture, that is adiabatic relation for an gas. Adiabatic relation for an gas, it is nothing but the PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. So in this case the correct answer is PV raised to gamma is equal to constant, option B. Next question is, van der Waals equation of state for a real gas is, option A, P plus A upon V square into V minus B is equal to RT. Next option, PV is equal to RT. Option C is given. Option D is there. We had seen that van der Waals equation of state is nothing but it is a correction to the ideal gas equation or general gas equation due to the correction, due to the two corrections in terms of the pressure and in the volume, due to a pressure and the volume. So the correction in the pressure term, it is nothing but the P upon P plus A upon V square. So this is the correction term in terms of in the pressure term, and minus B is the actual corrected volume. Okay, so correction in the volume. So this equation has the form P plus A upon V square into V minus B is equal to RT. So in this case the correct option is option number A, P plus A upon V square into V minus B is equal to RT. Next question is, in general gas equation PV is equal to RT. Van der Waals introduced a correction factor A upon V square in pressure. This term represents option A, effective area of the molecule, option B, mean velocity of molecules, option C, volume occupied by molecules, and option C, attractive force between molecules. So all of us know that in Van der Waals equation, two corrections were proposed. One is in terms of in pressure, and the second one is in volume. So the correction term in pressure, that is nothing but the A upon V square, and it is due to the correction between the attraction, between the attractive force between the molecules. So it is the option D which will be having attractive force between the molecules is due to that correction in the pressure term was introduced by the Van der Waals. So the correct answer in this question is option number D. Next option is question is the dimension of constant B in Van der Waals equation are that of option A, pressure, option B, volume, option C, pressure by volume, option D, volume by pressure. The all of us know that Van der Waals equations is P plus A upon V square, P plus A upon V square into V minus B is equal to RT. That is a Van der Waals equation. And in this one, the first term P plus A upon V square and the second term, which is minus B, these are respectively known as correction in the pressure and the correction in the volume. All of us know that in order to have an addition or subtraction of any two quantities in physics or in science, we need to have the dimensions of the two quantities must be same. Means in this case, as we are doing a subtraction of V and B, so dimension of V and B has to be same. So if you look it in that point of view, V is nothing but the volume. So if from that point of view, if you look at the dimension of the V, then it will be nothing but the dimension of volume. So the dimension of constant B in the Van der Waals equation are that of, the correct answer for this question is option number B, that's volume. Next question, in isochoric process, these are the option P is constant, V is constant, T is constant, none of these. All of us have studied, there are in our theory lecture we have discussed that different thermodynamic processes are, the first process is called as the isothermal process. It is the process in which the temperature of the system remains constant. Next thermodynamic process is called as isobaric process. In isobaric process, pressure of the system remains constant. Third thermodynamic process is called as the isochoric process. It is the process in which volume of the system remains constant. And the last process, important thermodynamic process, that is called as an adiabatic process. In adiabatic process, system neither takes or nor gives heat to the surrounding. Means there is no exchange of heat between the system and surrounding. Such a kind of process is called as the adiabatic process. In this question, it has been asked, what is the isochoric process? In isochoric process, if you see, in isochoric process, it is the volume. It is the volume which remains constant. So in this case, the correct answer is option number B, that is V is constant. Next question, during an adiabatic process, option A, T remains constant, option B, S remains constant, option C, U remains constant, option D, P remains constant. Actually, this is a problem based on the, means you need to understand the thermodynamics second law, that is nothing but it relates with the entropy. We know that entropy of a system, it is defined in mathematical form that dq is equal to tds. Dq is equal to tds is the mathematical form. For an adiabatic process, just we had seen, system neither takes heat from the surrounding nor it gives heat to the surrounding. So net heat content exchange between the surrounding and system, that is zero. So if I substitute this value in this equation, I'll get dq is equal to zero. So tds is equal to zero. So in this case, I'll be getting the equation TdS is equal to 0. As for adiabatic process, we cannot say anything about the temperature, so it may not be 0. So from this equation, we get dS is equal to 0. Okay, so as dS is equal to 0 means change in entropy of the system is equal to 0, means entropy change is equal to 0. This implies that this quantity has to be constant, then its change will be 0. So in this case, if you see, during an adiabatic process, we are getting a condition that S is a constant. So the correct answer in this case, it is the option number B, S remains constant. Now, next question is, in isobaric process, option A, pressure is constant, option B, volume is constant, option C, temperature is constant, and option D, none of this. All of us know that in isobaric process, pressure remains constant, as we had seen in our earlier slide. So in this case, the correct answer is option number A, pressure is constant. Now, the ninth question is, an adiabatic process occurs at option number A, at constant temperature, option B, at constant pressure, option C, at constant heat, option D, none of these. All of us know that in case of an adiabatic process, the system neither gives heat to the surrounding nor it takes heat from the surrounding. So in this case, the net heat content of the system remains constant. So in this case, the correct answer is option C, that is heat, since in adiabatic process there is no heat exchange. Next question, number 10, the gas law PV upon T is equal to constant is true for isothermal change, option B, adiabatic change, isothermal and adiabatic, and option D, one of these. Okay, we know that this expression PV upon T is equal to constant, PV upon T is equal to constant, it is an, if you consider this relation, if I transfer this T from this side to this side, so this T will get multiplied to this constant. Let us say this constant is R, let us say. So it will be having a form PV is equal to RT. So this PV is equal to RT, it is an ideal gas equation for a 1 mole of a gas. So if you, in that point of view, if you look at this option, then it is the equation valid for the isothermal as well as the adiabatic gases. Okay. So that's it for the today's session. We'll stop here for the today's lecture. Thank you so much.